three races, the first two in each, and the next two fastest across the three semi-finals will go through to the final, which will be the last event tomorrow night at 10:15. We had some brilliant running in qualification. We've got some of the fastest men in history. Local interest as well, but in severe qualification. We've got eight men in each of the semi-finals, only the first two guaranteed a place in the final, so nice and quiet for the start. A lifetime spent preparing for this journey for some of these sprinters. So we'll introduce them to you one at a time. Let's pump up the volume for these men. In semi-final number one, lane two, Olympic relay silver medalist for Trinidad and Tobago, Emmanuel Callender. In three, 10:01, Forsen Kitson Nevis, Jason Rogers. In lane four, a world relay bronze medalist for Canada, Gavin Smelly. In five, two silver medals at the last Commonwealth Games for England, Adam Jamili. And stand by with the volume as we welcome back a heat winner, the fastest Australian in a decade, Trey. Seven, 9.69, second fastest human ever for Jamaica, Johan Blake. In eight, world indoor bronze medalist for Barbados, Ramon Gittins. And in lane nine, second at the African Championships representing Nigeria, Ogo Okine Aguero. That's the lineup, nice and quiet for this first semi-final of the men's 100 metres. Commonwealth record 9:88 at Oldham in 98. On your mark.
So,
three winners in this lineup. So, two alongside him. That's Gittins. Gittins looks like he's on the charge, but so too Jamili. Well, Jamili left him running very late in that heat. It's a fabulous start by Trey Williams when we watch the replay. But with only two to go through, Blake confirmed and Jamili in second place. Those will be the guaranteed finalists tomorrow night.